Hello everyone, welcome to Homeschool. We are with the last part of a chapter called Diversity in Living Organisms. So we have studied about how various organisms are divided into five major kingdoms. And later we studied what divisions come under the kingdom Plantae, each and every division's characteristics we studied. And later we studied the various phyla that come under a kingdom Animalia, right? So all those characteristics of the phyla we finished, and at the end we are with another important topic, that is nomenclature, right? So what do you mean by a nomenclature? It's very simple. Nomenclature is a process using certain rules created by botanical organization and zoological organization. You know, we are giving scientific names to an organisms. So such a process is called nomenclature. Okay. So in simple, what is nomenclature? It is a way of giving scientific names for an organism is called nomenclature, right? Say for example, tiger is there. Say in our India, tiger is called with different names, isn't it? In Hindi, we call tiger differently. Say in various languages, tiger is called with different names. And if you go to the other part of the world, you know, tiger may be called with another name. Say, ultimately, a person gets confused, right? Say, it is nice that if a tiger has one common name, right? So that's the reason, that is the main aim of giving scientific names to an organism. It is to avoid confusions. Okay, so if you know the scientific name of a particular organism, you know, in every part of a word, they can understand this scientific names, you know, with respect to a particular organism, right? Say, the scientific name of tiger is, you know, Panthera tigris. You know, this is the scientific name of a tiger. So, whichever place you go in a world, if you say Panthera tigris, it means tiger. Okay, in their local language, tiger is named in a different way. Tiger would have had a different name, right? In our India itself, we have so many languages. Each and every language has a name for a tiger, which is very, very different. Right? Say, just to avoid this confusion, say we should have one common name for a particular organism which should be accepted in every part of a world. Okay? See, if you know that the scientific name of tiger is Panthera tigris, whichever part you go in a world, if you say Panthera tigris, it is tiger only. Right? Say, sometimes even an English word for tiger is tiger, right? In many parts of the world, English is not used, where they won't even understand what do you mean by tiger, right? But if you say Panthera tigris, they will understand that it is tiger, right? So scientific names are accepted by everyone in the world, right? And these scientific names are kept according to certain rules. They are not kept however they want. Okay. So these names have been given to a particular organism according to certain rules, guys. Okay. So we are now learning the rules of binomial nomenclature. So we have something called binomial nomenclature. So, what do you mean by binomial nomenclature? So, here the organism's scientific name has two parts. Okay, so bi in the sense what? What is the meaning of the word bi? Bi means two. isn't it? So the name will have two parts here. Say for example, my name Nalini Polina. Nalini is one part, Polina is another part, right? So binomial nomenclature system where the scientific name has two parts. Okay, so here the first part is called generic name. Generic name. Okay, and the second part is called specific name. Specific name. Okay, you know what do you mean by generic name? See, generic name is nothing but the name of genus. Specific name is nothing but the name of species. Okay, see, by knowing the binomial nomenclature, say for example, tiger is called with Panthera tigris. Panthera tigris. Okay, so Panthera is the genus. It indicates to what genus the organism is belonging to. Okay, and tigris is species name. Species name. Okay, Panthera is a genus name. This is called, the first part is called generic name and the second part is called species name. Okay, so you all know the animals have divided into five kingdoms. Yes or no? So kingdoms, they are divided into five kingdoms. Each and every kingdom is divided into division or phyla, right? Each and every division and each and every phylum is divided into class. Later, each and every class is divided into order. Every order is divided into family. Every family is divided into genus. Every genus is divided into species, right? So, looking at the name, you can easily find out whether an organism belongs to what genus and what species. Okay, so the binomial name actually gives lot of information. Say, looking at this name, I can say that the tiger belongs to this particular genus and it can belong to this particular species, right? Say, looking at the genus and species, you can able to find out what characteristics it has and you can able to compare its characteristics with the characteristics of another organism and you can do a lot of study also, right? So, name is not just a name. It is giving lot of information about a particular organism, like whether an organism belongs to what genus and what species it can be called as, you know, everything you will come to know, right? So the very first point you need to understand is the name has two parts. One is generic name. Generic name is nothing but we indicate the name of genus, and specific name is nothing but name of the species we will mention, right? And now, there are certain rules for writing binomial name. Rules for writing binomial names. Okay, so what are the rules here? The first rule here is, you know, name of genus. Name of genus, that is the generic name, the first part of the name. You know, this is the first part of a name, this is the second part of the name, right? So the first part of a name is talking about to what genus the organism is belonging, right? So the name of the genus should start with a capital letter. Should start with a capital letter. See, Panthera, I started by writing capital P, isn't it? So, name of the genus should start with a capital letter. And the second point, name of species, that is second part of the name. Second part of the name is species name. Okay, name of species should start with a small letter. Small letter. See, species name is tigris. Small t I have used here. right? So this is how you have to write the name. And the next point is, you should underline the generic and specific name separately. You should underline them separately. See here. I did not write the name like this. See, Panthera tigris. See, I did not underline with a single line. See, I underlined Panthera separately, tigris separately. Isn't it? So, generic name and specific name should be underlined separately. You should not give a single line. Right? Underlining is compulsory when you write the name. And how you have to underline? You should underline separately. The first part of a name separately and the second part separately. Right? And next one, when you print the name, okay, say when we print the name, okay, or when you are giving the names in a textbook or various books, you know, you have to print the books, isn't it? So during printing, the name should be in italics. The name should be in italics. You should follow what font? Italics font. You should follow italics font. Clear? So these are the four rules we have to keep in our mind before writing any scientific name. Okay. So this is the scientific name for tiger. Isn't it? Now, another example I'll give you. Scientific name for humans. You know, what is the scientific name? Homo. This is the genus. Genus name. Homo sapiens. Homo sapiens. Okay. So, this is a generic name. This is a specific name. Generic name means it is the name of a species. Say, human beings belong to what species? What genus? They belong to a genus Homo. Okay. And this is a species name. Okay. So, human beings are called with what? Sapiens. So, this is a species name. This is a genus name. Clear? So, this is the first part of a name. Homo, I started with capital letter, underlined. Specific name, I started with small letter and I have underlined it. Isn't it? Say, this is Homo sapiens, scientific name for humans. And like that, we have certain plants. Okay. So, whose scientific names I'll give you? Mimosa, pudica. Okay. And another plant, vinca. Vinca, rosea, okay. So these are some examples of plants. You know, these are the garden plants. We see these plants, these flowering plants in our homes itself. In a day-to-day life, we can find them, right? So this is how we have to name different organisms according to these rules, okay. And you know who has given this binomial nomenclature? It was given by a scientist called Corollus Linnaeus. Okay. So, he is the scientist who has introduced binomial nomenclature. So, here the major thing you need to remember is the name consists two parts. One is generic name, other one is specific name. Generic name is talking about genus name. Specific name is talking about species name. Okay. So, always the name has two parts. And what are the rules? When you write the genus name, that is generic name, you should start with capital letter. When you write the species name, you should start with small letter. And you should underline them separately when writing in a book. But when you have to print, the name should be there in what font? It should be there in italics. Okay. So these are the various rules and various points that you have to remember about binomial nomenclature. Say, you can search the scientific names of various organisms. Search a scientific name for peacock. Search a scientific name for lion. Search a scientific name for monkey, tomato plant, potato plant. You see, you will get different sort of names. you know, all these names, the generic name, specific name, you know, Panthera, Tigris, Homo, Sapiens, all these are derived from Latin words. Okay, they took all these names from Latin language, right? So this is all about binomial nomenclature. With this, I am completing the chapter Diversity in Living Organisms, right? So we will meet up with another chapter. Till then, take care and please like our video, share and subscribe our channel to learn the concepts in the easiest way and in a detailed way. Thank you so much.